For the school year of 2015-2016, I moved to Cartwright, Labrador to embark on a new adventure in my life. It was a great year. I enjoyed the community, my students, and everything else involved. I most definitely enjoyed the beautiful big land outdoors. Labrador offers a wilderness experience that can be rivaled with any other place in the world. Some call it the Alaska of the East. I caught plenty of big fish, snowshoed, hunted, skidooed, went on a traditional trap line, and had the year of my life. At the end of the year, I decided to go on a canoe trip. This trip would take me 50 kilometers from the Dykes River down to the Sand Hill River and out to the ocean, 3 hours away from Cartwright, where I had a ride organized to pick me up. Come along and enjoy the ride that I had. Experience it through my eyes. Sit back and relax. In typical big land fashion, it wasn't long until I got a tug on my line.
First trout.
This big brook trout fought like the devil. I was glad to get him into the canoe and into the pan later on that night. After paddling 10 kilometers down Dykes River, I had a 2 kilometer portage that would bring me to Big Beaver Brook Pond.
So, canned canoe here, pulling it, I suppose. And those Labrador flies are really holding their own here. And I'm just trying to battle through them.
Intersected by a small gully, this portage was filled with uncertainty.
Found a portage. It's not a bad trail. A little better than the last pass.
You can never have enough knowledge. For this trip, I took advice from local woodsmen and forestry officers. They helped refine my route.
That's always a good sight to see the next pond. That means that big dirty portage is over with.
I know I'm not going to get a few fish out in this one. Thing is, I already got a big whopper mud trout, probably 3 pounds. I don't really need another one, but I'll definitely catch and release just for the fun of it. Sweating like a pig now. What a beauty spot.
Now it's back to get the canoe. Hip hip hooray.
Oh my. Anyways, that's it. Dragged out a half a kilometer and can't wait to paddle on that pond. It looks gorgeous. Can't wait.
Risk of black bears and even polar bears on this trip, on night one I opted to set up camp on a large island in the middle of Big Beaver Brook Pond. I had my 12 gauge along for protection, but you never know in this Labrador wilderness. The views were remarkable. Sometimes on these trips it's hard to contain my excitement, and from time to time I will let out yelps of joy. And longs to be stoned, still and quiet and on the ground. Released from the rush of town, laying me down in an easy
trout there, brookie.
Turning sideways, in one of these viciously flowing rivers, with spring thaw pushing its way down, put me in some thrilling situations. Out here, you can never let your guard down.
In the science show.
This particular rapid was about 1 kilometer and threw at me everything it could offer.
Here we go. Almost to Myra Pond. Make my way down this rapid. Black duck.
Comfort provided by this little cabin I found in the woods was much appreciated. Once I left my mark, I felt the presence of the others who had been here before me. I had 5 kilometers to go the following morning as I made my way closer to the resettled community of Sand Hill, the finish line of my trip. I was eager to get going, and the day was large. As I paddled down the remaining leg of the Sand Hill River, I stumbled upon 2 Gander River boats that were docked at a small lodge.
Hello! What are you at, boys? Just calling yourself?
When I got close,
I gave a holler. For a paddle.
The boys joked, thinking I was a Viking from days long gone.
What are you fellas at?
I stopped in, had a quick drink, a good old yarn, and then I was on my way again, inching my way towards the Atlantic Ocean.
I just left the lodge there. I met a few lads from Newfoundland, a couple salmon guides who were up just preparing a hut for when they take some fishers up throughout the summer.
As I made my way up Sand Hill Pond, one of the guides from the lodge behind me had crept up and offered a ride to the start of the rapids I had to go down to reach the ocean.
What's that?
If you're high enough, you'll be okay on this side.
Left side, you say?
Yeah. But you can go short. If you
want. Yeah, I'm going to go scout it out anyways.
Yeah, that's best,
eh? Alright, thanks, boy. That's big help.
Stupid. I should have brought you down before.
Oh, no worries, boy. I don't mind a paddle, but.
Ross Smith has been guiding on this river for 40 years and ran the rapids in both his Gander River boat and a canoe.
What's there?
That's the ocean.
Yeah.
Right there.
Oh, well, that's a pool there. You got the high tide comes into them rocks.
Well, I just got a bit of advice from a local guide I met up with back on further up the Sand Hill River, Ross Smith from Hare Bay, actually down from where the barbers originate from, down by Newtown that way. Hare Bay's along that road. But anyhow, Ross gave me some tips on how to run this rapid that's going to take me out into the ocean. So he's going to stay down there on the rock, and I'm going to run away. Here goes nothing. Riding the rapid straight out of Sand Hill River.
to the ocean, Atlantic. Let's go.
Arriving at the resettled fishing community of Sand Hill signaled the end of my trip. The beauty can only truly be witnessed in person. After traveling almost 50 kilometers and having one hell of a ride, I was ready to be picked up.
It's 7 o'clock, Sunday, June 26th, and I'm just waiting to get picked up here. Overall, been a hell of a trip. And just dip my canoe into the Atlantic, and it's a nice little paddle.
The kindness and willingness to help is found everywhere in Labrador. Jeff Martin came 3 hours from Cartwright to pick me up. It was a blessing, and I couldn't have thanked him more.
Huh? Is there? So did you have to navigate through that, or what?
There's a land of boundless beauty where the untamed rivers run and majestic snow-capped mountains.
The icebergs are around down here, I'd say, hey.
3 hour boat ride back to Cartwright was icing on the cake. Magnificent icebergs and rugged coastlines capped off one of the most interesting years of my life.
And it was pretty cool.
And all that.
Legends of our people spoken in the language of the land. Tell of hard times and endurance strangers would not understand as they trekked across the tundra from the highlands to the shore. Promise of the land is broken and our people suffer more. Let her unspoiled waters flow. Let her children live in freedom in the valleys of the snow. Lift your voices, sons and daughters, like you've never done before. Let your song rise through the darkness in this land called Labrador. Lift your voices, sons and daughters, like you've never done before. Let your song rise through the darkness in this land called Labrador. In this land called Labrador.